How can we communicate God's love in a noisy world?
Let's start by moving back 50 years. The year is 1971. The first microprocessor was invented. The Soviet Union launched the first space station into low Earth orbit. And Pope St. Paul VI approves the new pastoral instruction entitled Communio et Progressio. What can a document from such a different time teach us about communicating God's love in the new digital world? What does Communio et Progressio mean for us today?
Communio et Progressio.
Communio et Progressio.
Communio et Progressio.
Communio et Progressio ni mwanga.
Is truth and freedom.
Signifie connexion et créativité.
Is foundational and hopeful.
일치와 사랑입니다.
Is inspiration and responsibility.
Comunione e speranza.
È sal e luz.
Authenticity and adventure.
Is dialogue and innovation.
Wamuasiliano e imani.
Is unity and solidarity.
Es una provocación al encuentro.
Is accountability and education.
Ay pakikinig at pagkakaisa tumo sa isang direksyon.
Comunio et Progressio es compromiso profético.
The Church has always had the duty of scrutinizing the signs of the times and of interpreting them in the light of the Gospel. Thus, in language intelligible to each generation, she can respond to the perennial questions which men ask about the present life and the life to come, and about the relationship of the one to the other.
From the communication of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost to the TV coverage of the Second Vatican Council, the Church always seeks to engage with God's people through various mediums.
Communio et Progressio teaches us that because of social communication, the individual is more closely bound to his fellow men and can play his role in the unfolding of history as if held in the hand of God. This quote reminds me to look beyond my daily tasks and remember that in all types of communication, God's grace is always present.
In 1971, Communio et Progressio brought forth a new vision for engaging with the world from a Christian perspective, seeking above all to engage in communion as the body of Christ and share the gospel across all mediums. This document set out to provide guiding principles and pastoral guidelines. It would, 50 years later, serve as the starting point for 16 young adults from around the world to come together to learn, engage, and be proactive about the ways in which they communicate the faith in an ever-changing world of social communication.
Dans Communio et Progressio, c'est écrit que plus les communicateurs apprennent à connaître leur public, plus ils le comprennent et l'apprécient, plus ils adapteront leur message avec ceux qui le reçoivent. Alors, si tous les communicateurs apprennent à faire ça grâce à des formations, on contribue à faire du processus de communication une communion d'esprit.
As communicators of the faith, we carry with us a profound responsibility and opportunity to proclaim the gospel's message of hope and solidarity in creative and innovative ways.
Espero que sean suficientes 50 años para que despertemos a la identidad y misión que nos propone Communio et Progressio. Y que seamos cada vez más sensibles a los signos de los tiempos y con creatividad empática, redescubramos nuestra capacidad de enriquecer la cultura y las relaciones humanas, también en el mundo digital.
Across all borders and throughout all time, the call of Communio et Progressio remains. May we never lose sight of the immense gift social communication offers us in the pursuit of unity, justice, and truth, of witnessing to the light of the gospel in our time.